Imagine you're in a car, cruising down the highway at 80 miles per hour. You don't even really notice that you're moving, most of the time, until perhaps the driver turns the wheel really sharply, and then you fly to your left or to your right. Or they slam on the brakes and you lean forward into your seatbelt. Or they slam on the gas and you are pressed back into your seat. All of those are examples of what's called acceleration. Really important way to get a grip on what acceleration is it's something you feel. If you are accelerated, you'll notice that motion. And in this lesson, we're gonna dive really deep into just what acceleration is. Let's learn. First, let's review our lesson objectives. We'll start by defining acceleration. Then we'll introduce the units of acceleration. And lastly, we'll calculate acceleration. This motorcycle is moving at an incredible speed, but as long as it's staying at the same speed, its acceleration is zero. Let me show you what I mean. Now that's acceleration, a change of speed, getting faster. When we think about the definition of acceleration, we have to remember that it's a vector. A vector that tells us the rate of change in velocity. What in the world does that mean? Well, remember that a vector is just something with a direction. So, for example, we could accelerate forward or backward or to the right or to the left. It has a direction and it tells us the rate of change in velocity. Let's think about something that accelerates really fast. This is called a top fuel dragster, and it goes from 0 to 330 miles per hour in 3.6 seconds. That's some fast acceleration. To understand acceleration a little better, we should think about it as how fast something speeds up. That pretty much captures it all. We just need to tack a direction onto that. Okay, now mathematically, we can think about acceleration as being the change in velocity over time. We'll write that change in velocity a little differently. We'll use this weird little triangle thing here. Whenever you see that in this class, it always means change. It's actually the Greek letter delta, and it just means change. So we take that change in velocity and we divide by time. Okay, let's go ahead and calculate acceleration. Here we're told once again about our top fuel dragster. It increases its speed from 0 miles per hour to 330 miles per hour. In just 3.6 seconds. How fast is it accelerating? Well, we're gonna solve for acceleration by plugging in the change in velocity up top, which we know it's 330 miles per hour faster at the end of its acceleration than it was at the beginning. And we're gonna divide that by the time it took to accelerate, 3.6 seconds. So what we'll get out then is 91, and then we'll get a bunch of sixes, 0.666. We're gonna round that up to 7. And that's miles per hour, that's the unit up top, and second is the unit on the bottom. Now that's a pretty weird unit. Now normally we don't leave acceleration like this. Normally we always require that this hour unit for time and this second unit for time be the same. And we'll look at an example like that in just a second. But it's actually kind of nice to look at it in the split units for just a minute, because this is what acceleration is saying. Every single second, this car gets 91 miles per hour faster. So at 0 seconds, it's going 0 miles per hour. At 1 second, it's going 91 miles per hour. At 2 seconds, it's going a whole another 91 miles per hour faster, or a total of about 180 miles per hour. So every single second, it gets 91.7 miles per hour faster. All right, in this problem, we're gonna calculate the acceleration of a motorcycle as it goes from 20 meters per second, which is about 45 miles per hour, to 31 meters per second, which is about 70 miles per hour. So you can think here about going from maybe typical surface street speeds, 45 miles per hour, to highway speeds, about 70 miles per hour. This acceleration takes 2.2 seconds. What is the average acceleration of the motorcycle? Well, to calculate this acceleration, we're going to need the change in velocity. And that means we're going to need to think about how the change in velocity is equal to the final velocity minus the initial velocity. That's just actually the way we always calculate changes, is final minus initial. So here what we're going to do is we're gonna go ahead and plug in the final speed, which is 31 meters per second, and we'll subtract from that the initial speed, which we know is 20 meters per second. That gives us a change in velocity of 11 meters per second. Okay, so now we're ready to actually calculate acceleration, which is going to be equal to the change in velocity, 11 up top, and divide that by the time, which is 2.2. When we divide those, we're going to get 5.0. And that's meters per second. That's the unit of time there that we have in our velocity. And that's per second. That looks kind of weird. Meters per second per second. Well, what does that mean? Just like we saw in the previous problem, that means that every single second, it gets 5 meters per second faster. Now, physicists have a funny way to draw this set of units. They'll draw it as 5.0 meters per second squared. So they'll put a squared there on the bottom to tell us that that there's actually two separate seconds. So there's a second and there's a second. And we're combining those together with this two there. So whenever you see in the denominator there, the bottom, a squared, that tells you that we're dealing with two of those S's, or 2 seconds, and an acceleration. This problem tells us that a space shuttle is accelerated to 8,100 meters per second, really fast, from rest, that means sitting still, in just 8.5 minutes. What is the acceleration during this period in meters per second squared? Well, in this case, notice that it asks for the acceleration in meters per second squared. Our velocity is in meters per second, so that looks great, but our time is in minutes, and that doesn't match any of those units there. So we're going to need to take those minutes to seconds first. Go ahead and pause the video and give this calculation a try. If you get stuck, just hit resume. Did you get stuck? If not, great job. If you did, let's go ahead and work it out. So we're going to start by converting our 8.5 minutes to seconds. And remember that there are exactly 60 seconds in every 1 minute. So now our minutes cancel out and we just multiply by 60 and we're going to get 510 seconds. That's how many seconds our acceleration took, okay? And now what we want to do is go ahead and actually calculate that acceleration. Here we'll put the change in velocity up top, which is 8,100. And we'll put the time on the bottom, which is 510. That's going to give us 16 meters per second squared. So that means every single second, the space shuttle got 16 meters per second faster. That's some fast acceleration. Okay, let's work one more practice problem. Here, what I want you to do is think about how the units tell us if something down there below is an acceleration, a velocity, or a displacement. So this is kind of a cumulative review. Now, keep in mind that I want you to pause this lesson now and try to figure out for every single one of these if it's acceleration, a velocity, or displacement. Okay, now let's go through them. 60 miles per hour is just a velocity because it has one unit for distance and one unit for time. So that's a velocity. B says 12 miles. Notice there's no unit for time there at all. So all we're thinking about there is a displacement. C tells us 15 miles per hour squared, and that's the telltale sign that we have acceleration when we have the two down there. When there's two units of time, we have acceleration. So similarly, 72 meters per second squared is an acceleration because we have seconds twice. Okay, then for E, we have 2.3 miles per second. Now, that's just the same units that we've already seen. It has one unit for distance and one unit for time, and they're just spelled out. So 2.3 miles per second is a velocity. That's how many miles we're going every second. Lastly, we have 142 feet per second per second. Okay, again, this is spelled out, but we have two units for time, which means once again, we have an acceleration. Let's review what we've learned. We've defined acceleration. We've said that it's a change in our speed with a direction. So we get faster or slower or we turn, those are all acceleration. Then we've introduced the units of acceleration, which we said uniquely have two units for time down there in the denominator. And lastly, we've calculated acceleration. Hey, hey.